This is Marilyn Lohman, Service Hydrologist at WFO Pendleton. We'll be taking a final look at the snowpack and water supply conditions for the 2018 spring and summer, looking at current snowpack conditions and expected water supply. This is a map of measurements of the snow water equivalent or amount of water being held in the snow as of early May 2018 for the various basins across the state of Washington. From this map produced by the Natural Resource Conservation Service, we can see that the amounts were near 100% of normal in the upper and lower Yakima basins. The lower Snake Basin was showing 128% of normal, and within this basin, the Walla Walla Basin had peaked at about 100% of normal. We'll look at some individual stations across the area. These charts show the snow water equivalent or water held in the snow for the water year October through September. The blue line is the maximum observed, while the green line is the average and the red line the minimum. Using these charts, we can see how the snow water equivalent accumulates through the winter and spring and compare it to average. The Touchet Snotel site is in the Walla Walla Basin, around 5,500 feet. Looking at the black line, we can see that this snowpack peaked in mid-April at slightly below normal values and continues to decrease steadily. The Sassy Ridge Snotel site is located in the upper Yakima Basin at 4,200 feet. Looking at the black line, we can see that this location had the snowpack peak in mid to late April, with amounts near normal for the year. The next site is the Bumping Ridge site at around 4,600 feet in the central Washington Cascades. Looking at the black line, as per the previous sites, the snowpack reached a peak in mid to late April with amounts near normal. Looking at the snow water equivalent map from the NRCS for Oregon, as of early May, we can see that much of the snowpack has already melted out of the John Day Basin, with only 50% of normal remaining in the upper Deschutes and between 80 to 90% of normal in the Umatilla and Grande Ronde basins. We'll look at some individual sites across the region. For the Northern Cascades of Oregon, the Red Hill Snotel is at elevation 4,400 feet. Looking at the black line, the current year observation, this site reached a peak of snowpack around mid-April and it was near normal and is steadily decreasing. In the upper Deschutes Basin, the Three Creek Meadows Snotel site is at about 5,600 feet. Looking at the solid black line, we can see that this site reached a peak snowpack in late March. The snowpack was well below normal and had melted out by the beginning of May. Overall, the snowpack for the Upper Deschutes Basin averaged only 50 to 65% of normal. For the John Day Basin, we had to switch to the Lake Creek site at 5,200 feet. The snowpack in the John Day Basin peaked at about 50 to 70% of normal in mid to late March, and much of the mid-elevation snowpack had melted out by mid-April. For the Umatilla Basin in the Blue Mountains, we could look at the High Ridge site at 4,900 feet. Looking at the black line, we can see that this site had the snowpack peak in mid-April, slightly above normal. Overall, snowpack in the Umatilla Basin was around 80 to 90% of normal. In the Grande Ronde Basin, the Moss Springs Snotel site at 5,800 feet. Looking at the black line, the snowpack peaked in mid to late April as well, with amounts above normal. Overall, in the Grande Ronde Basin, the snowpack averaged from around 80 to 90% of normal. The Northwest River Forecast Center uses Ensemble Stream Flow Prediction, or ESP, generated forecasts as the official water supply method. The 30-year runoff normals covering the years 1981 to 2010 are being used. New ESP forecasts will be published on the forecast website daily. For updated forecasts and more information on ESP forecasts, please see the River Forecast website at the address given. This map from the Northwest River Forecast Center shows a snapshot of the water supply forecast for the coming season. As of early May 2018, water supply for the Pacific Northwest ranges from well above normal conditions over much of Idaho and into portions of northern Washington to below normal water supply for southeast Oregon. We'll take a look at several stations within our area of responsibility for a little more detail. For the Yakima River system, we'll look at the Yakima River near Parker. Looking at the plot, the solid green line is the 30-year normal. These plots show the entire range of forecast values, with the blue dot the 50th percentile, or most likely value. We'll be comparing that to normal. The volume forecast for the Yakima River near Parker for the period April through September is expected to be about 120% of normal. The forecast volume of water, the blue dot, for the Grande Ronde River near Troy is expected to be about 86% of normal. This value has decreased slightly from the 98% of normal seen at the beginning of April. These forecasts take into account the expected precipitation for the next 10 days, then normal precipitation throughout the rest of the period. For the Umatilla River at Pendleton for the period April through September, the volume forecast is at 95% of normal. Once again, these forecasts take into account the current 10-day forecast and then normal precipitation through the rest of the season. The Columbia River at the Dalles is an indicator for the entire Columbia Basin. Once again, we're looking at the average value plotted in green, with the most likely value the blue dot. The volume for the April through September period continues to increase and is at 123% of normal. The previous seen plots and additional water supply locations are available in an interactive form on the Northwest River Forecast Center's website at the address listed on the concluding slide. The 3-month outlook from the Climate Prediction Center for May, June, and July calls for above normal temperatures and below normal precipitation. Here's the web address of the Northwest River Forecast Center where you can get the additional and updated water supply forecasts. This will be the last briefing for the spring 2018 season. Join me again next winter when we'll once again look at the snowpack and water supply conditions. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please contact me by email or phone.